Hello and welcome to another sneak preview. The topic is how to create your own custom joints in SolidSteel Parametric for SolidWorks. We will also show in detail how to use the custom joints in practice in another video. You can find the link in the description. Let's start with a frame corner. We can do this as usual with the normal functions in SolidSteel. I'll just speed it up a little, so that we can get to the actual topic faster, since we've already shown how this works in detail several times in other videos. With the end plate tool, we'll connect this profile to this column. I already saved the matching end plate as a template. Now the haunch plate follows. Dimensions are adjusted as desired, and of course with a chord plate and matching width. Then we'll insert a few ribs at the usual places. So now we have finished building the frame corner, nothing new up to here. If we wanted to build the whole thing once again over here, we would have to repeat all these steps exactly the same way. To make this easier, there is now the new function custom joints. That means we can create joints once, and then use them again and again. Let's do that now and use that new create custom joint function to do it. First, we'll define the profiles involved. This profile connects to that profile. Inside this joint there are these parts, this rib, and also these ribs. And of course this end plate. Here we can see, displayed in green color, that the cuts for the holes have also been recognized. We want to include the bolted joints as well, and we can do that with one single click. And now we only have to assign a name for the joint, and can then confirm. That's it. From now on we can use this complete frame corner over and over again. One more example right away. For the stage beams we'll also create a custom joint. I'll speed up the normal processing in the video again. Let's start with a cope cut. Now the clip angle connections follow. We'll use a European standard template from the database. On the opposite side another one, the tool has remembered the inputs, very convenient. The bolting follows with manual boltings, because the clamping lengths are varying. Of course including the standard mountings, that is the washers and the nut. We'll do the same here as well, so that everything is securely bolted. You can already see that there are quite a few steps until such a connection is completely defined. With a design in which such points are present dozens of times, the time required for this adds up quite a bit. We'll just add one more rib here and the connection is finished. Wonderful! Now we'll create another custom joint by starting the corresponding function again. To do this, we'll select this profile again. We want to connect it to this one. Then we'll select the components. This. This. And the rib. And of course, we'll also select the screw connection again in the options. Now all components are defined, but we still need the cope cut, which we did at the very beginning and which should of course be created automatically in the later custom joint. We'll open our assembly, select the IPE beam and expand it, and insert the cuts here at beam cuts in our custom joint. The cut surfaces are then also highlighted accordingly, so you can see clearly that the cope cut has been added. We'll give the new joint a name and confirm. With this we have created two custom joints, and now we will test them in a new assembly. The three beams needed for the test are already placed here, and we will see the time savings quite clearly in a moment. Let's start again with the frame corner. We'll use the insert custom joint function and simply select this beam that we want to connect to this support. Then we'll select the joint we just created from the list, and select cut end beam as well as insert bolted joints in the options. We see the detailed preview and can confirm immediately. There is our finished frame corner. Such a frame corner can be constructed manually with SolidSteel quite quickly, but we already saw that it took more steps to reach the goal with the clip angle joint. Now with the new function, it's as simple as selecting the beams, selecting the custom joint from the list, setting the desired options, confirm, and within a few seconds the connection is finished. As already mentioned at the beginning, you may also take a look at the video linked in the description. There the custom joints created here are used to design a complete steel framework in a short time and, among other things, the new bracing tool is also presented. It's worth watching. But now I will show you another complex custom joint. With the custom joint function, you can create almost any individual connection. Here, as an example, I have placed two rather large profiles, which we now want to connect with a custom joint design from sheet metal. Same tool as before. We'll select this profile and that profile. Custom joint from our list. Immediately see the preview. And the ribs on the back side were also considered. Now we are immediately ready to insert the connection with a click on confirm. The joint is instantly inserted, and we will take a look at one of the components. As we can see, all edits have been correctly applied to the part. Of course, you can also export a DXF file from the part. Just enter an order number. And here is our DXF file for production. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to show it by liking the video and subscribing to our channel. For further questions, don't hesitate to contact us via our website, for example. See you next time and goodbye.